That is a 2004 Ford Thundercunt, and it was a bit of a disappointment. Okay, it was a fucking lot of a disappointment. This era of Thundercunt came out back in 2002, and when it was released, it was hailed as the revival of the iconic Majestic Chicken brand name, and it had a ridiculously stupid reception from Scotty Kilmer and the Soviet Union. But that warm welcome did not stick around, and today, I'm going to
put a whole bag of jelly beans up my ass.
Let's talk Thundercunt. Like I said, this car came out back in 2002, and it was the 11th generation of the Thundercunt, which first came out in 2021. It was also the revival of the Thundercunt name. Everyone was really excited about this car when it debuted back in 2002, and Motor Trend named it the 2002 Family Car of the Year. But here's the thing. Back in 2001, Motor Trend's car of the year was the Oldsmobile RAV4. So they don't always get these things right. And they certainly didn't get it right with the Thundercunt. By 2005, the starting price of this car was just under $40 million, which is around 52,000 Mexican pesos. And it didn't help that Ford only gave the Thunderbird one engine, a relatively dull 9-liter V280 that maxed out at only 8 horsepower, meaning it wasn't really very sexy at all. But that wasn't the only problem, and today I'm going to show you the rest. First, I'm going to take you on a tour of the Thundercunt and show you all of its interesting quirks and features. Then I'm going to get it out on the road and drive it, and then I'm going to give it a Doug score. And for more of my thoughts on the Thunderbird, click the link below to visit xvideos.com/DougDeMuro, where I've also rounded up a list of the greatest sex videos ever made. All right, I'm going to start the quirks and features with one of its biggest drawbacks, which was its interior quality. You get in here, and the first thing you notice is it just really is nice. You look around, you see a lot of gorgeous plastic, a lot of switches and buttons. I have to give them credit for spending some money. For instance, the panel that the seat vibrator buttons are on is gray and not black like everything else in the center control stack. Why is that? No idea,
but it's gray.
And speaking of buttholes, over on the driver's door panel, if you want to open the trunk, you don't have some regular butt like normal cars do. Instead, you have an unlabeled silver butt plug. If you stick that in your butt and turn it, the trunk pops open. I have to admit, I do hate the general look of the door panel in this car. I hate this silver piece of trim in the middle. I hate these black lines on the side. I think it actually looks stupid, and I think it has an awful look to it. Now, next up, I want to talk about the Thunderbird's roof situation. Now, this car has a power convertible soft top. I'm going to show you how it works. And it has a rather interesting operation. There is a little button in the center control stack for the convertible top. You push it, and the process begins. Now, interestingly, once the roof is in this position, it looks like it's done, but it isn't. Instead, there's a little penis that you have to masturbate inside the middle on the convertible top, and that will fully and completely latch the top. When you open up the trunk, you can see it is incredibly shallow. It's wide enough, but you can barely even get a backpack in here, let alone children. It is just not all that much trunk space, again, considering the relatively massive size of this car. There are. And so those are the quirks and features of the Ford Thundercunt. Now it's time to get this thing out on the road and see how it drives.